For Galilee, and found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethesda, that's the town of Andrew and Peter.
That's right.
Philip found this dude named Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one that Moses wrote about in the law, and the prophets also wrote about. Jesus is his name. He is from this place called Nazareth. And he's the son of this dude named Joseph." Verse 46 says, "Nathanael replied, 'Can any good thing come out of Nazareth?'" Evidently, he had a problem with where a man came from. He says, "Can any good thing come out of Nazareth?" Philip replied, and I like this short verse, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him and exclaimed, "Look, a true Israelite, a man that has no God."
Make it plain, Doc.
I didn't see them.
But they saw you.
I know I'm not the only one that traveled and had this experience. Call myself getting away.
Yes, sir.
Let my hair.
Yeah.
Discovered they saw me.
Yes, sir.
And I didn't see.
Yeah, sir.
There were times when you were hundreds of miles away from home, or stumbled into a familiar face.
Yes, sir.
On a supermarket, in a shopping mall, while attending some public activity. Someone gazing at you. And you died. You didn't see them. But they saw you.
Yes, sir.
When I was small, we used to play this thing called hide and seek. Where can anyone hide in your house that you cannot be found?
All right.
There's just too many places you can hide. They are usually always found, even those who hide themselves in closets and cupboards and on the beds and even in their clothes pockets. I don't care where you find yourself at. Somebody always finds you.
Yes, sir.
It's an eerie thing. Eerie feeling to be watched. In secret. I don't know about you, in this technology world that we live in, there everybody got phones that can record and, tape, and then we have people that can edit real good and make things seem to be what it's not. It's a dangerous time. When folks see you, but you don't see me. Can I get a witness right here? Watching me in secret.
All right.
That's why we install curtains at the house and blinds in your home and put dark tint windows in your cars and we protect our email addresses and we don't even want to put our card in the service station thing because you scared somebody for God knows all of our identities and our hiding places. Even in our thoughts.
You
see, you understand something, if you think it long enough, you don't have to hide it because it's going to come out. Because out of the heart, the mouth speaks. Can you believe that your heart can think? Because the heart is the seat of one's emotion. I know what you're saying. I can hear you. I can hear you. No, it's my mind that's doing the thinking. Yes, true that, but I'm telling you now, the heart can think too, because your mouth don't never say nothing that your heart ain't already.
That's right.
There are times that I just get away just to be getting away because I don't want to deal with nothing else. But everywhere I go, I find out that it's God that I serve. He always finds me even when I'm in my hiding. Can I get with this right here? Psalms 139, 2 and 3 says, "Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou understand," here we go, "my thoughts afar. He said, "That is an Israelite."
that a different way?
Well,
I don't know why he didn't, because the way Nathaniel came to him.
Yes, sir.
And unbeknownst to Jesus, Nathaniel had already dissed him.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Because they say, can't nothing good come out of Nathaniel. Because Nathaniel already had a problem with where he's from.
Yeah,
yeah. He already had a problem who his daddy was.
Wow.
And who they say he is. Y'all help me somebody.
Yeah.
He already had a problem, so evidently he already had some stuff in the streets of Nazareth.
Y'all help me right here.
Understanding this, I want you to understand that some people are going to have a problem with you before you get that, because of what they already assume they know.
Jesus could have answered that
he knew Nathaniel before he was born. He could have went deeper.
Yeah.
Look, man, I knew you before you were born, before you were shaped in your mother's womb. I already knew you.
Yeah.
He could have said that while he was yet a heartbeat in his mother's womb, he observed him. He could have said before his existence, he even thought floating in the eons of time, he already knew him. But Jesus' answer would have been too confusing for a small man in Nathaniel. Jesus answered him by saying in John 1:48, before that Philip called thee, I saw you when I was under the fig tree. I saw.
My God, Reverend.
Come on. That's what we're talking about right there.
Yeah.
Well, before Philip called you.
Yes, sir.
I had already peeped you out.
Yeah.
I already saw you when you thought you was in your hiding place.
Yeah.
When you didn't want to be bothered with nobody, I saw you.
Yeah.
Not only did I see you, but I want you to understand, I knew what was bothering you while you was under the fig tree. Understand something, I already cursed the fig tree because it gave me an illusion, it had something that it didn't.
All right, brother.
Now you sitting under a fig tree with not an illusion, but you think you got something, but you don't.
Yeah.
I saw you when you didn't
see
me.
Yeah, Reverend. My God.
The Bible says now that the table's turned.
Yeah.
The agenda and the personality of Nathaniel begins to change in front of Jesus.
Well,
because that was enough right there to convince Nathaniel that Jesus was the Lord.
Well.
Because he knew that only a man that God or God himself could discern, would bring discernment that a man of God or God himself could have known that he was under.
Well.
Right.
The fig tree, because I made sure.
Yeah.
They give me the explanation that sometimes you have to be seen
Yes, sir.
First,
before
you can grow.
All right.
Y'all ain't tired.
Go ahead, Reverend. You got to help. Go ahead, Seth. My God.
This scripture implies to me.
Yes, sir.
That he didn't become a believer.
All right.
Until he was saved.
All right.
Until he was seen in the hiding place.
Yeah.
He did not become a believer.
Make it plain. Make it plain. Make it plain.
And a sure enough disciple.
Make it plain.
Until he was seen in his hiding place.
Make it plain, Boone.
I went to see his face when Jesus said, I saw you.
I saw it.
Under. I can imagine Jesus paused for a minute and give time to think. I saw you under. Yeah. I saw you. I saw you under! It's like, what's the name? The fig tree! Oh,
there you go. Yes, sir.
The Bible then said that convinced Nathaniel right then to become a believer.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Jesus revealed some great truths about himself when he responded to Nathaniel. See, what I'm getting ready to show you now does not tell me much about Nathaniel, but it tells me more about Jesus. Check this out. Jesus tells me about his heart, how he responded to Nathaniel. Now, these truths allow me to give me insight into how God sees us as well. Can I have you right here? Look at number one. Number one, he sees us at worship.
Yeah,
he sees us at worship.
Yes, sir.
Now watch this.
Yeah.
You know, it was a commonplace in the Eastern culture to have a place of worship and prayer.
Yeah, that's right.
It was not unusual for men to be praying
under
the tree.
That's right.
The text does not tell us exactly what Nathaniel was doing under the tree.
Or
under the fig tree. Common practice.
If
you give me time to assume.
Well.
If he was doing what normally was the custom.
Yeah.
He could have been.
Yeah. Worship. That's right.
He could have been worshiping.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
Now allow me, because I want to do this because I need to be exegetically correct and hermeneutically sound here.
Yeah.
Even today, the Lord sees us in a moment of worship.
Yeah.
When no one else is looking, he sees us and hears us.
Yeah.
He sees our devout and contract spirit. He hears our prayers.
Yeah.
If we look around in this room, we can't see him, but he can definitely see us. What for Nathaniel, that point of contact was a fig tree. For you, it might be your dining room table in a quiet time of the day. It might be a special moment that you spend on the side of your bed as you begin and end your day. It could be on your knees. Your fig tree could be climbed to the top of a mountain. Abraham made sacrifices before an altar. Jesus went into a garden. We know about the garden. It might be the same garden that the songwriter said. Yeah.